Today, Theodorakis is a professional politician dividing his time between politics and music. He remembers well his first foray into rebetika, which shocked Athenian intellectuals back in 1960. He dared to use the low-class bouzouki, a rebetika singer, to perform his setting of a poem by Nobel Prize nominee Yanis Ritsos.
The bouzouki had become associated as an instrument with the lower classes, the lumen proletariat, during a difficult period in Greece. The rembetes, as they were called, were people oppressed by society. They found no other means to express their opposition to society except in escape. So they created the hash dens, where they took refuge like hunted animals, where the bouzouki player expressed this precisely, the social and spiritual oppression which the rembetes suffered from.
Interestingly enough, Theodorakis is not completely happy about the recent rebetika revival.
I believe that this is both good and bad. It is good to return to our traditions, but when this becomes a substitute for a contemporary movement, it is bad. That is to say, it's a romanticism, an unhealthy nostalgia. And that, in my opinion, is due to an ideological confusion and a spiritual sickness that followed the military dictatorship in Greece.
Probably the most visible sign of change since a dictatorship is the physical appearance of Athens itself. Nearly half the entire Greek population now lives in the Athens district. The rapid expansion has brought the usual urban ills of pollution and bad planning. Air pollution is worse than in any other city in Europe. Car ownership has skyrocketed. There are now two cars for every three people in Athens. Not even the Acropolis, the finest example of classical Greek architecture, can escape the pollution. Despite surviving more than 2,000 years of war, earthquake, and bombardments, the white marble columns and statues are disintegrating.
Parthenon is the biggest temple on the hill of Acropolis you can see from here, okay? Situated at the...
But still, the tourists come by the millions, drawn not only by the ancient sites of Greece, but by the celebrated nightlife of the Plaka Quarter of Athens. Every tourist who has seen Zorba the Greek is searching for the excitement and color of Greek music. And the nightclub owners of the Plaka are only too willing to oblige.
Όπως πετάνε σε ένα σκύλο το ψωμί.